Public Works and Highways Department says dozens of roads affected by Christine are now open to traffic. According to the agency, of the 93 road sections impacted by floods or damaged by the storm, 68 sections have been reopened. The DPWH says they deployed thousands of personnel and units of heavy equipment to conduct clearing and road repairs. According to the department, quickly reopening transport routes is crucial in the speedy distribution of relief supplies. The Office of Civil Defense in Region 5 expects the delivery of humanitarian aid to pick up as floods recede in Camarines Sur. This means more assets and large equipment will now be able to pass through to bring relief supplies. So far, only two communities in Albay remain isolated, but Air Force assets are expected to deliver aid there.
Yesterday, the concerns were mostly on the entry of the occupation assets from the different region, specifically Camarines Sur, because San Fernando or area itself is one of the main entry points going to Pili and Naga, and Nabo Camarines is also heavily flooded. But as of this morning, Nabo is now passable. So any air asset that may land at Bicol International Airport carrying response personnel and food and non-food items can be jet-lift provided to Naga and Pili without going to the longer alternate route.
The death toll due to severe tropical storm Christine has climbed to 81, but this number still needs to be validated, according to the Office of the Civil Defense. The number of missing persons also went up to 34. The National Disaster Management Agency says over 4 million people were affected by the storm, internationally known as Trami. Flooding was also reported in nearly 2,000 villages across the country. The country's agriculture sector also suffered 87 million pesos worth of damage due to Christine. Government data show over 1,600 hectares of crops have been affected, impacting more than 3,000 farmers. The Agriculture Department says rice and corn fields in the Bicol region and Mimaropa sustained the most damage. In northern Luzon, agri losses reached 2.6 million. The Agriculture Department has vowed assistance to farmers and fisherfolk. It plans to request an additional 1 billion pesos from the Budget Department for the rehabilitation of the affected agricultural areas. Damage to infrastructure, meanwhile, was pegged at 203 million pesos. The Philippine grid operator says transmission services in Luzon are now back to normal after the onslaught of Christine. The NGCP says full services were restored early Saturday morning. The agency adds it was also able to find a technical solution in other affected areas such as Nueva Ecija, despite some ongoing repair in its lines. But the NGCP warns some technical issues in other facilities might still affect some areas.
Kung meron mga customers na wala pa silang serbisyo ng kuryente, maaring meron pang problema sa pasilidad ng kanilang mga electrical operatives or distribution utilities. Ang NGCP, siya yung highway na nagtatawid ng kuryente mula sa mga planta na nagpo-produce ng kuryente patungo dun sa mga distribution utility o electric cooperative. Kung maayos na yung highway, which is kami sa NGCP, pwede kasing yung mas maliliit na linya, meron pang problema, kaya hindi pa nakakarating sa mga bahay natin yung kuryente.
Philippine Coast Guard confirms an oil leak from one of the ships that ran aground in Batangas Province. The Coast Guard says automobile fuel had leaked from the motor tanker after it drifted toward the port of Batangas amid the storm. The vessel was recently seized by the Bureau of Customs. Fortunately, the fuel had since dissipated in the waters. The Coast Guard also gave assurance that its personnel are keeping a close watch on the two ships for possible oil leakage.
As of now, our personnel haven't seen any signs of leakage anymore. But still, we do not discount the possibility that oil leak will occur again. That's why our personnel is in collaboration with the customs who has the custody of the vessel.
President Marcos wants to revisit the Bicol River Basin Development Program after seeing the widespread flooding caused by severe tropical storm Christine. The chief executive cited his project as he vowed aid to storm victims. Harlene Delgado has tonight's top story.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. traveled to Bicol today to see the situation firsthand after Storm Christine battered the region and triggered massive floods. Together with his cabinet members and local officials, the president assured evacuees at the Naga City Hall the national government will extend all necessary assistance.
Dumaan lang po ako para makita na yung mga dala namin na tulong at kayo lahat kayo na kailangan mag-evacuate dahil nakalubog pa yung mga ibang bahay ninyo. Mabigat itong nangyari sa inyo at napakalaki ng tubig, kaya gagahanapan natin ng paraan yan.
During the situation briefing, Naga City Mayor Nelson Legacion said floods in the city reached as high as 12 feet, submerging 22 out of 27 barangays.
Sa ngayon, pitong barangay na lang po ang baha. Yung ilang portion ay hanggang dibdib pa rin. We may still be needing rescue boats kasi hindi pa po kami tapos sa rescue operation. Unprecedented po ito. First time na mangyari po sa aming lungsod.
Albay Acting Governor Gwen Ombongao also reported that over 92,000 families were evacuated in the province, with over 500 houses totally damaged. The estimated cost of damage to roads and bridges is 1.3 billion pesos, while agricultural damage is pegged at 10 million pesos. Both the Naga City and Albay government are requesting the Department of Social Welfare and Development for thousands of additional food packs for the affected residents.
We're okay, Mr. President. We're just having to use our Cebu center now to feed into Bicol.
After seeing the widespread flooding, Marcos stressed the need to focus on long-term flood projects, particularly the Bicol River Basin project.
We have to revisit it now. Iba na ang conditions ngayon. May flood control naman tayo eh. Pero hindi kaya yung ganito kadaming tubig. Hindi talaga kaya. Kasi never naman, walang forecast na ganito eh. Ito, climate change talaga ito. This is all new.
Floods in San Fernando and Miloor in Camarines Sur have slightly subsided, but some houses are still submerged in water. In Bula, Camarines Sur, some villages are also inundated. Residents here are in need of food and clean water.
Wala po kaming pagkain, tubig, kung ano-ano. Wala man lang ayudang nadating. Kailangan po namin ng pagkain.
In Albay, clearing operations are underway in areas where landslides occurred. Power supply has been restored in Libon and Bolangi, but affected residents are appealing for more aid and basic necessities.
Sa katotohanan po, nagkakaubos na ng supply ng bigas, gayon din ng gasolina at krudo. Kaya naman ang mga lokal na tindahan, hindi na po nagpapabili ng kanilang bigas. Kaya ang mga residente po na sa coastal area ay problemado sa kanilang pang-araw-araw na pangkonsumo.
Jorlin Delgado, ABS-CBN News.
More air assets have been tapped to deliver relief goods to storm victims. Presidential choppers landed Saturday at the Naga Airport, bringing food and other essentials donated by the private sector, including San Miguel Corporation and Frabel Corporation. The arrival of the aid came as President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. visited parts of Camarines Sur to check on the government's relief operations in the province. Southeast Asian nations will deploy air assets to the Philippines to support relief efforts after the storm. The Office of Civil Defense says Singapore, Brunei, Malaysia, and Indonesia pledged to help. The agency says the ASEAN member states will also send essential items for storm victims. Singapore's Defense Ministry confirmed it would send a C-130 aircraft, citing the deep bilateral and defense ties between Manila and the city-state. A state of calamity has been raised over the Philippine province of Batangas, where Christine triggered deadly landslides that left dozens dead. Jeffrey Arnaez tells us more.
With the help of K-9 units, the remains of 14-year-old landslide victim Kisha Viende Torres were recovered in the municipality of Talisay in Batangas. Kisha was the 19th victim of the deadly landslide that occurred in Sampaloc village. A severe tropical storm Christine dumped torrential rains.
Merong isang aso, isang aspin actually. Medyo inikutan niya po yung area kanina eh. So parang may indication po na andun yung isang biktima.
She will be laid to rest beside her 8-year-old brother who also lost his life in the tragedy.
Maramdam ko po eh, parang gusto ko na rin pong sumama sa kanila kasi dadalawa naman po yung anak ko, parehas pa po nawala. Tapos sumama pa po, nanay ko po kasama din. So, nangyari po sa situation dun sa lugar namin, parang trauma na po sa amin para bumalik po sa lugar na yon. Parang isa po siyang bangungot na nangyari sa amin. Kaya parang hindi na po kami dun babalik.
Search and rescue teams are still looking for the last missing victim, 2-year-old Amelia Faith Galope. Amelia's father and her uncle, who also lost 2 family members in the landslide, are hoping she will soon be found.
Sana hindi sila mapagod kasi naniniwala ako na pagod na din yung pamangkin ko eh. Ako hindi po ako napapagod, sana hindi din po sila mapagod.
Authorities assure the family, search efforts will continue. Tragedy also struck a family in Lipa City, where a landslide killed 3 people. The victims were identified as 25-year-old Marilu Llanes, her 9-year-old daughter Olivia, and her 9-year-old nephew Gray Nathan Llanes. Some groups and concerned citizens have offered assistance to the victim's family. Jeffrey Hernaez, ABS-CBN News.
Still in Batangas, Christine also wreaked havoc in the municipality of Laurel. The storm destroyed Bayungan Bridge, which connects 2 villages. The houses located near the bridge and several fish pens were also washed away. 10 people also died in the storm, and many villages remain isolated. A long line of vehicles can also be seen waiting along the boundary of Laurel and Talisay. Meantime, more than 300 families are currently staying in evacuation centers. Laurel Mayor Lyndon Bruce is appealing for heavy equipment to clear the roads.
Talaga po kami po ay nananawagan sa atin po mga kababayan, sa atin po mga national agency na kailangan din po namin sa madaling panahon na mga heavy equipment, dahil talagang yun po mga national road po namin, yun po mga daan namin papunta sa mga barabarangay ay halos barado na po.
At least 8,000 families also affected by the storm in Mulanay, Quezon Province. The town was hit by massive floods and landslides, displacing thousands of residents. The town mayor says Christine was the strongest storm they encountered in 2 decades. Residents are now appealing for help in their recovery efforts.
Number one, siyempre, damit. Immediate kasi, siyempre, lahat po ng kagamitan po, yung pinuntahan po nating sitio, ay talagang wash out. Yung mga underwears, yung siyempre kailangan brand new, at pagkain, at yung siyempre tubig po. Yung mga essentials po natin, kasi marami po silang nawalan din ng mga kalan, yung pangluto nila, yung mga kawali, lahat po ng ginagamit po natin sa bahay, wash out.
Pamilya Stars Unite to take part in ABS-CBN Foundation's online donation drive for victims of severe tropical storm Christine. The nation's girl group, Beanie, showed their support by donating 1 million pesos. MJ Felipe has that story.
The onslaught of Typhoon Christine left many families homeless and severely affected. ABS-CBN Foundation, together with ABS-CBN Entertainment and ABS-CBN News, organized a multi-platform donation drive to raise aid for those affected in the Bicol, southern, and northern regions of Luzon by Typhoon Christine. Kapamilya stars like Ann Curtis, Donnie Pangilinan, Amy Perez, Vina Morales, Jamie Rivera, KD Estrada, Kyla Estrada, Jed Madela, Jonah, Nyoy Volante, Jeremy G., AC Bonifacio, Angie Salvacion, Fana, Kimo, Pinoy Big Brother Gen 11 ex-housemates, and BGYO took part in the 3-hour telethon hosted by ABS-CBN News Chief of Reporters Jeff Canoy, reporter Victoria Tulad, Migs Bustos, and resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. These celebrities believe that this is an effective way to send help to those who need it the most.
All of us, not just us on cam, but even those behind the camera, it's our social responsibility to raise awareness of how people can help. Ang daming nagtatanong, even on our social media platforms, paano po pwede tumulong? This is a way to reach out to those who really want to lend out a helping hand.
In moments like these, we really have to stick together and we really have to take care of each other, especially because this is something that happens to us often. And I feel like if we were victims of a tragedy like this, we would also want people to help us out.
Hoping kahit konti, like people will watch this and they will donate, and ako personally, I will donate talaga. We are gonna make you
a better world. Nation's girl group Beanie also participated and donated.
Ilang tulong po ng Bini at ABS-CBN po sa mga nasalanta ng Bagyong Christine. Kami po ay magdo-donate ng 1 million pesos po galing po sa aming Grand Biniverse Concert para matulungan po natin ang mga nasalantang kababayan.
But even their families and friends weren't spared from the typhoon in Bicol, Batangas, and Isabela.
May ibang parts sa bahay ng friends ko binabaha, like same with sa ibang regions, talagang unexpected na binaha, first time binaha doon. Pero they're okay naman na, and signal number one na sa Isabela ngayon.
Coping pa rin po yung relatives ko po since malapit po sila sa dagat nakatira. Pero I hope na maging okay po sila as soon as possible kasi parang up until now, mahirap pa rin po sila i-contact.
Ang daming parts po talaga na as in binaha, yung iba nga po, yun lampas tao na po yung baha. Wala na rin supplies. And yung sa electricity po, brownout, tapos mga unexpected na places na binaha po talaga.
Meanwhile, Bini member Aya appealed to pet owners to also safeguard their fur babies in times of calamities.
Ang dami ko pong nakita online po na naiwan yung mga aso at pusa nila. Sa mga lahat dyan na may mga pets, sana alagaan nyo po and wag nyo itali. Tsaka huwag nyo kalimutan kasi sila din naman po may buhay, so alagaan po natin sila.
More than raising funds, Bini Joanna believes that
it's about showing solidarity and compassion sa mga fellow Filipinos natin.
MJ Felipe, ABS-CBN News.
The ABS-CBN Foundation continues to raise funds for victims of severe tropical storm Christine. Partial donations by Saturday afternoon reached nearly 6 million pesos from bank deposits, e-wallet platforms, and pledges. Now, the foundation continues to accept cash and in-kind donations through different methods shown on your screens.